All right, so we're continuing in Matthew chapter 15 with just some really important points from Jesus about religion, false religions. He says this in verse 13, after the disciples said that the Pharisees were offended at Jesus, he says, "But he answered, every plant which my Father, Heavenly Father, didn't plant will be uprooted. Leave them alone. They are blind guides of the blind. If the blind guide the blind, both will fall into a pit. So the first point is that God, and I think we've covered this in a previous video, is that God sowed faith into this world. God is not the author of evil. That Satan became jealous, became prideful, and he sowed independence and pride into this world. And so he literally has offspring in this world, spiritual offspring, and even Jesus said that to the Pharisees, I believe it was in John, that he was saying, you know, your father is Satan and he's a liar from the beginning, something to that effect. And so, you know, that's a sad truth, but it is that way. And here's what I wrote in my commentary. The harsh truth is that everyone does not belong to God. So we must be willing to move on whenever we encounter clear disinterest in the gospel. And then just the sad part about the blind leading the blind. You know, when I try to explain to people that DNA proves God's existence, people are literally blind to it and they don't want to believe it. And they've got this blindness in them. All right, verse 15, Peter answered him, "Explain the parable to us." So Jesus said, "Do you also not understand?" Now, this is the parable that Jesus said. Let me back that up. He said, "Hear and understand, that which enters the mouth doesn't defile a man, but that which proceeds out of the mouth, that defiles a man." So Jesus said, "Do you still not understand? Don't you understand that whatever goes into the mouth passes into the belly and then out of the body? But the things which proceed out of the mouth come out of the heart. They defile man." All right, so religion, false religion, because religion just means worship of a particular God. And so Christianity is a religion. It's a relational religion. And Christianity is about changing us from the inside out, based on the fact that you are accepted by God apart from your behavior. That's huge. So if God wants us to love each other, man, he's got to fill our hearts with love. That's what the gospel does. By us realizing that Jesus died for me and he has a place for me for all eternity where there will be no pain, all pleasure, you know, that I am accepted by God apart from my behavior, that fills my heart with love. And that gives me the ability to love other people because I'm taken care of. You've probably heard the phrase, hurt people hurt people. People who are experiencing hurt will hurt other people, but people who are experiencing love will love other people. So that's why Christianity is important. Other religions, they don't want you to be good from the inside out. They want you to try to focus on the outside in with your behavior. And here's what he says comes out of the heart. Evil thoughts, murders, adultery, sexual sins, thefts, false testimony, and blasphemies. These are things which defile the man, but to eat with unwashed hands doesn't defile the man. And so Jesus is criticizing religion that focuses on the outside in and things that don't matter as much, because what matters is that we love God with all our heart, mind, soul, and strength, and we love our neighbor as ourselves. That's how we should be living. That's the sign of someone who has accepted Jesus as their Lord and Savior. And they've got the energy to serve other people. And they've got the love in their heart to serve other people. Here's what I wrote in my commentary. We must be cleaned from the inside out. Beware of religion that just tries to clean up the outside. So be very cautious of that. You know, if you see people involved in these things, murders, adultery, sexual sins, thefts, false testimony, and blasphemies, man, that's just a sign that they need the love of God in their heart. And so God doesn't want us to clean ourselves up and then come to him. God wants us to come to him broken and addicted to things and having evil thoughts and having evil tendencies, right? And then you come to God and he fills us with his love, and we can renew our minds and how great he is. And there needs to be this balance between trusting in God's love and this healthy reverential fear of God. That we don't want to hurt him and we don't want to hurt people. Because if you disobey God, and God's will is perfect, and God's will is best for the people around you, you should have a reverential fear that if I disobey God, I'm hurting myself and I'm hurting the people around me. So have that. So just understand, Christianity, we want to change from the inside out. False religions, they want you to change from the outside in. And it's all about your soul, the health of your soul. And by accepting Jesus Christ, accepting his love, by renewing your mind, you are filling your soul with the love of God. And look what it did to Paul. Look how he was willing to die. Paul even said he would be willing to go to hell for other people because he just didn't want to see other people cut off from God. That's really good. And that's where we all should be. You should get to that point where you just love God, you love other people, and you would be willing to say, man, I wish I could go to hell for these people. Of course you can't. Jesus did that for them, but you should be willing to take their place. That's the love of God, and that's a healthy soul.